On Facebook, I think it's more of just I'm friends with everyone, people who I've never seen, or really ever, once or twice. It's a way to learn about someone on a really basic level.
I check my Facebook, but I'm not on my Facebook. I look at it every day to see if I have notifications, but I'm not glued to it. I'm unfortunately glued to the other ones, like everyone, which is why we all like have neck problems. And
Instagram, I view more as like a personal online visual journal. I don't have as many followers as I do on Facebook. It's a little more private for me because Facebook at first was private, but then it became this monster, this huge beast. Instagram now is a huge platform as well, but I'm a little more hesitant and careful of who I accept and who I follow.
My Instagram is full of skyscrapers and tabletop pictures with hashtag foodie on it.
I follow people on Twitter and I'll search things on Twitter if I want instant news. You know, if somebody just told me something or I know something just happened, I'll type it into Twitter because that'll be the most current, you know, before it even happens, Twitter knows about it.
I love Snapchat.
Snapchat, I think, is my favorite social media, honestly, now.
Snapchat, I use basically just like a quick little fun game.
I like Snapchat just because I can quickly show people what I'm saying and then it's gone. So it's not something I have to analyze for a while. I know if I post something on Facebook, a lot of people will see it and they have like opinions about what I'm saying. If I take a Snapchat of what I think something's just like stupid and I'm like, hey, look at this, it's gone.
Snapchat to me is like a form of texting. It's a little bit more casual. I don't know why it is, but it is. So I like that too. So if like you've just met someone or a recent friend or whatever, it's a less like, I don't know why, it sounds odd saying it, but serious way to talk to someone.